Semi-finals action continues here on day six of the US Olympic track and field team trials. The road to Tokyo is getting serious. Semi-finals in the women's 200 meters. And as we went to the break, we promised you you'd see Alison Felix, and here she is.
Her only individual gold medal is in this event. She's also a three-time world champion in this 200 meter event. She's in lane nine. Sometimes you think, oh, lane nine is a disadvantage. Not for Alison Felix. The strength of her race is the straightaway. She'll be happy to run as little turn as possible.
Saw some wonderful family images when Alison finished second in the 400 final. There's Cameron, her daughter.
And that's her brother and manager, Wes Felix.
So in a stark contrast of experience level, but still a great story, is Cambria Sturgis coming off winning the double at the NCAA championships.
And you might think that happens often. It doesn't. The last time it happened was in 2016, Ariana Washington for Oregon. She's only a sophomore, Lee, and usually the shortest in the field, but it has not been a disadvantage for her. She powers through the turn and the straightaway.
And here's Jenna Prandini, who will start in lane five. Personal best last evening in qualifying. She ran the second fastest time in qualifying, and she kept Alison off of the 2016 200 meter U.S. Olympic team.
And I'm sure for her, like many of the Ducks, it's just something about competing in the stadium, and she looked incredible in the prelim. Nobody runs a lifetime best, a personal best in their preliminary rounds, and she did, so she's in great shape.
And Alison is going to have to get out very aggressively on the turn. You don't want to just leave it late at this stage of qualifying.
Top three in each semi, then the next two fastest times go through to the final.
Can you left foot back, please? Two. That's good.
Felix out wide in nine. She's got Morlakeya Kinnison inside.
And Morlakeya's close the stagger on Alison Felix. Look at Prandini in the middle of this race. She'll come off with a big lead. Alison Felix with some work to do, but she's in a good position.
Flannel on the inside, Jenna Prandini. Here comes Alison Felix down the outside. Top three go through to the final. Alison is going to the final in the 200. Prandini wins. Felix gets second.
Another personal best for Prandini. She is rattling them off and looking like three people will not beat her tomorrow in that final.
And the way Alison looked in the prelim, compared to how she looked in the semi, once again, you just cannot count Alison Felix out when it comes to championship running. There is Jenna Prandini there in lane five, Alison Felix in lane nine. Like you said, Otto, this was to her advantage, to run less turn, to have that big turn, and then be able to go to her strength, which is the final part of the race. Jenna Prandini there over 20 miles an hour and completely in control, dominated the turn, and was able to look around and really relax coming home. And Sturgis, who I thought would compete way better, only seventh.
The collegians are out of gas, some of them officially. So Alison Felix is into yet another Olympic trials final.
Tremendous second half of the race by Desiree Bryant to get that auto qualify to the final. So Jenna Prandini, Alison Felix, Desiree Bryant, Lewis going through.
Absolutely, and she said one more race now to this next final. So Alison in the heat, out in lane nine, just give us some thoughts on this race.
I was way out there, so I really had to run a good curve and give myself a chance, and I'm taking this all in. Like I said, it's my last time.
All righty, we'll look forward to seeing you there.
Thank you, guys.
The final is tomorrow, and it will be the last time we get to see Alison Felix run at a U.S. Olympic Trials. Who have already been told, well done, you're going to Tokyo. Great performance. And that's where we continue the storyline here, establishing who will be the finalists in the women's 200 meters. Second semi-final and one of the favorites in lane six, Gabby Thomas.
The Harvard grad said she never even knew how the Olympic trials worked, said she never had intentional dreams for track and field, but her senior season or her junior season at Harvard, she was the NCAA champ and decided to go pro and then made the move to Austin, Texas, where she trains with Tanja Buford Bailey and a group of elite women which includes Ashley Spencer and Morla Akinnison. You see Tanja Buford Bailey there, an Olympic bronze medalist, who says it's a joy to train Gabby Thomas. She's doing her master's, but she says the way she compartmentalizes, the way she handles the workouts is like no other.
And here's a young lady who had a brilliant NCAA campaign, second at the NCAAs at 200 meters. One of her coaches is Carmelita Jetter, the SEC champion at both 100 and 200 meters.
Cassandra Hall starts on the inside. Quinera Hayes, who's already on the Team USA team heading to Tokyo because of what she did in the 400 meters. Kyra Jefferson and Anavia Battle, all inside Gabby Thomas there.
And the way Gabby Thomas looked in those heats yesterday, setting the fastest time in the world, I expect her to dominate this semifinal. Brittany Brown got the silver medal at the last World Championships in 2019. She's also going to be a big threat. Tiana Daniels in lane 9. She's already made the team in the 100.
Second semi of the women's 200, and this is a stacked field.
And Gabby also ran a lifetime best yesterday, running under 22 seconds. We'll see if she comes out with that kind of running today as well. Off to a great start.
She was surprised by how fast she ran. She said she eased off when she ran that 21.98. Tamara Clark is coming on strong. Gabby Thomas, 21.94. She goes even faster than her heat.
So just like Jenna Prandini, back-to-back personal best times for Gabby Thomas. The wind is legal at 1.8.
My coach always told me, when you run 48 one time, you didn't really run 40. You got to run it two or three times. You want to say you're sub 49. Well, I'll tell you what, Gabby Thomas can officially say she is sub 22. She's a sub 22 200 meter runner, which is a barrier that all 200 meter runners hope to surpass. And she's doing it comfortably, back-to-back rounds, and still looks like she's not even out of breath.
Son, yep. She said that she has so much expectation on herself that she's been nervous. Addo, she doesn't look like she's running nervous.
No, she doesn't, and she shouldn't be. This performance makes her 10th fastest American all time, and it's what she's doing in the turn that's setting up the straightaway. She's running so well, her transition from turn to straightaway is just perfect. And now, all these quarter miles that she's been running, she is so strong to the line. Three people aren't beating her, and three people aren't beating Prandini. So good luck to Allison Felix and everybody else trying to get that final spot, because these two are not going to be beaten tomorrow.
Gabby Thomas, the 24-year-old, the Harvard grad who is continuing her studies now in Texas, is having quite the meet. She ran 11 flat in her 100 heat the other day. Now she's twice run sub 22 seconds in the 200 meters. Anavia Battle with a terrific finish to grab second, and Tamara Clark. And I can tell you one time, Morla Akinnison and Lena Irby will go through as the next two fastest qualifiers from their time.